Well, it certainly doesn't feel like gardening weather outside, but the flowers will be blooming before you know it.
In this week's Grow With Care, Laura and Bobby show us the growing popularity of dahlias and give us some tips for planting the popular flower.
Dahlias are becoming one of the favorite flowers of a lot of people, and the sizes, but really the color is what they're all about.
There's such a huge variety, and they bloom all the way from midsummer up until a killing frost. And here's my favorite. They multiply themselves.
They do multiply, and they're easy to harvest.
They are. So we are borrowing the planting bench at the beautiful 101 Market today to plant some dahlia tubers. To be viable, you need three parts to your tuber. The actual root, the tuber part, the neck, and then some eyes on there. The little parts that will grow into your stems.
So what you look for in a tuber is, it's got to be like a carrot. It's got to be hard, and you don't want it soft. Wrinkling is okay, but you do need those three components.
So we're going to start in a pot or a hole in the ground about 12 inches deep, and we're going to fill that halfway with a mix of either good potting soil and compost or your garden soil mixed with compost, damp but not wet.
Place the dahlia in the hole with eyes facing up and a tuber lying sideways. Fill the remainder of the hole with the soil.
So here's a trick I learned from my friends Kevin and Christy at Heartland Blooms and Berry Farm. That's where we got these tubers. Don't water your dahlia tuber right when you plant it. Wait until you see it growing out of the pot or out of the ground. Watering it too early and it will rot instead of grow.
And when they start growing, you really need to keep it moist. You may have to stake them because some of them do get very high. They're very heavy feeders, so use an organic all-purpose fertilizer and fertilize it all through the growing season.
Now these are not hardy, meaning they won't survive the winter here. So in the fall, after a killing frost, either take it out of your pot or dig it up from the ground to save it for next year. And I think this fall we'll have to talk about how to save your tubers.
Right, and this is what she likes best. You get one, next year you get two or three, and then you're up there at four or five.
To be continued.
For more on this topic or other gardening tips, log on to care11.com/grow.